I have this professor at Stanford named Andrew Ng. When people ask him what AI is good for, he says AI is like electricity. It's not good for one thing, it's good for everything. Because of the recent breakthroughs in AI, it sort of opened up this unprecedented opportunity for smart, hardworking, innovative people that are willing to develop AI-first solutions. One thing that you're seeing right now in the space is this evolution to more power-hungry chips and higher density configurations. The amount of power required to train a large language model or run inference workloads at scale is really substantial. People are looking at gigawatts of additional capacity that needs to be built and developed in order to support demand coming from AI. When we started Crusoe, it really was trying to take this energy-first approach to building large-scale compute infrastructure that could drive down both the costs as well as the environmental impact of developing the platform for innovators to build advanced technology. Crusoe has really kind of like taken the opposite approach that people have historically taken with data centers. And so instead of thinking about it like, where do I want the data center? We think about where is energy low cost, clean, and abundant. That's not a secret to anyone in the AI ecosystem, is that GPU compute is very, very expensive. We're budgeting 125 kilowatts per rack for that. So this is multiple orders of magnitude bigger than where we were just a couple of decades ago. What that means is that we fundamentally had to reimagine and redesign data centers from the ground up. We're talking about a massive investment in infrastructure capital to support the data centers, to support the new energy. This is something that relies on a number of different partners in the ecosystem, ranging from NVIDIA, Vast, Deloitte, Crusoe, RunAI. Specifically for training, what matters is not the GPU, it's not even the node, it's actually the cluster. So the cluster is really the product that people are interested in. The Vast platform really helps us obfuscate a lot of that complexity in terms of where data gets stored, how it gets used for our customers in their specific compute clusters, provides a simple interface into accessing a global data set because they have this global namespace implementation in their platform that makes it simple and easy to use. From a scalability perspective, we're really thrilled to partner with Vast Data because Crusoe has data centers around the world. We're focused on building data centers in locations that have low cost, clean, and abundant energy so we can effectively, sustainably power innovation taking place in AI. We're sort of at this point where AI has like this positive convexity to it, where it has this really positive feedback loop, where as the models get better and it becomes easier with architectures to do it with more and unique data sources to make models smarter, they become more useful. And as they become more useful, people use them more. And as they use them more, it creates more data, which makes them smarter, which makes them more useful. And it's sort of this nice flywheel effect that is only made possible by immense amounts of collaboration across the industry.